Today we're going to talk about using the XLOOKUP function to perform a match type that is either an exact match or the next smaller item if an exact match is not found. So in this example here, we have a list of past due clients, the number of days delinquent each client is at the given moment. And what we'd like to do is perform a lookup with the lookup value being days delinquent and our lookup array being our past due threshold amounts in this column, and then our return array being the delinquency buckets that we want to pull back based on these thresholds here and put them in the appropriate delinquency bucket category. So we'll begin with equals XL. From there you can hit tab. Our lookup value is going to be days delinquent. Our lookup array is going to be this list of past due threshold amounts. We're going to hit F4 to lock that down. Our return array is going to be our delinquency bucket categories. We'll hit F4 again to lock that down. Now this next argument, since we're not doing a complete exact match, we're doing an exact match or the next smaller item, we should always pull back a match. So there's really not a need to enter this next argument to return a value if a match is not found. So I'm going to hit a comma to pass over that argument. And then we get to our match mode. And we want this second option here, exact match or the next smaller item, which is a -1. So now you can see that Kate Smith is 30 days delinquent, and there is actually an exact match on this list. But if I change that to one day short of 30, you can see it changes the delinquency bucket to under 30, which is the return value for our next smallest item in our lookup array. So that is how you can perform the XLOOKUP with an exact match or the next smaller item.